They say you should invest in properties, and we listen. But simply buying isn't a strategy, it's a transaction, and we are about so much more than that. So, when it comes to the different strategies to invest in real estate, you need to know the options. I put this brief guide together to help you understand what the main strategies are, what they mean to you, and how you can implement them. Ciao, my name is Salvatore Leggero. I'm an entrepreneur with a passion for finance and real estate. Now, without a further ado, let's look at the different main approaches to invest in real estate. I call them the fantastic four ways. Buy and hold is one of the most overlooked strategies when investing. Even if we have in mind the image of someone buying a property massively under market value and flipping it, more on this I'll tell you later, there is a great deal of value in buying and holding for years. Buy and hold is a long-term strategy, and what we know in the long term is that property, if properly selected and bought for a fair market price, appreciates in value. It's the same with just about any class of investment. This is one of the most famous Warren Buffett-style strategies that depend on selecting the right company, buying its stocks, and holding. We are told to take the long-term view. Even in real estate, prices can change in the short term, especially in some cities. Be prepared to ride out the ups and downs. They are all part of the game. But over the more extended period, the overall trend is upwards. In buy and hold real estate approach, the investor's focus is on the asset. So the principal essential parameters to consider include the location, the developer, the quality of layout and design, the finishing, the presence of a famous brand, the price, of course, and the payment plan. The goal when you buy for holding generally is to increase value. So often you use savings and secure them in something tangible that has less volatility and represents a defensive strategy in an inflation period. With this strategy, your goal is to hold on long enough for a significant price appreciation. In the meantime, you can rent it out, making a regular income. You can personally enjoy the property or just leave it as is. My recommendation here is to create an income while the property appreciates in value. A win-win situation. It takes a long-term commitment to the property and you have some vital cash tied up in the asset. But this is where you can make safely serious money. Passive income. Not all of us have the time to manage a property portfolio full-time, and that's okay, you don't have to. Passive income is a buzzword that is thrown around everywhere, but without enough substance behind it. This is the dream of all of us, to pocket money automatically, without really any effort. Passive income in real estate investment terms means you hand off with the transaction from start to finish. There are a few ways of doing this, and trusting an experienced real estate professional to do the work for you. They will source the tenant of your property, you approve it, and then manage the rental for that property. This means you get all the benefits and none of the downsides. After all, who wants to be called out at 3 in the morning for a burst pipe? Short-term rentals are another moving part of the market. You buy somewhere in demand and then employ a short-term rental management company to look after the place, including leasing it on all the major sites such as Airbnb, investing in REITs or similar property investment vehicles. These generally provide lower returns because the fund managers and others involved in the scheme tail their cut first, but they are a way of starting out putting your cash in property. You'll be one of the subscribers, and in this case, you're investing more in a financial product than in properties, with the advantage to resell your quotas in seconds. Passive income is a dream for many. However, with properties, it can become a reality, You can find a full video on my personal strategy to obtain really automatic income. Flipping. I mentioned this briefly earlier, and I'll go into more detail here. Flipping a property is buying cheap and selling on in a brief period of time. The idea behind this is that you can make a good slice of money in no time at all. Unlike some of the information you might find about this strategy, it isn't a get-rich-quick scheme. The most critical factor when flipping is time, because time means money. The longer it takes to get a property ready for market and get it sold, the more your cost can add up. If you're paying a mortgage on the place, you want those monthly mortgage payments to be as minimal as possible. If you've paid cash, then you want your money back out for the next one. If you want to go deeper, you can watch my video dedicated to this meaningful way to invest. Value add. This is where it gets really exciting. What happens when you take a property and make it more desirable? Now, this isn't necessarily about adding an extension or double glazing. Instead, this is about things such as buying land and obtaining the necessary permits to build on it, or splitting a plot so you can build multiple properties on it. And here's the process. Study which city a neighborhood has potential to be demanded. Select a relevant property or plot of land. Make a deep due diligence to ensure you can ask value. Buy and obtain permits for the works. Complete construction or renovation. Conclude management agreement of the property. Then you have the option of a hold or better exit. Value add is one of the most interesting aspects of investing in real estate and bringing some exciting returns. This way to invest could seem more complicated, and depending on your knowledge, it is. You have to consider that the value add strategy requires more of your involvement, especially your entrepreneurial skills. Usually, you've invested more money, but your returns can be an incredible double-digit number. I made many value-add developments in my life, investing millions, especially with brownfield projects. I'm always here to answer any question you have and support you on your real estate investment journey. And yours? Which investment strategy is your favorite one? Which one of the fantastic four is my favorite? What do you think? Since there's no way to know for sure which strategy will perform the best or avoid dips in the near term, my strategy is to invest in all of them at the same time. Please feel free to drop me a line to let me know which are your favorite approaches, and remember that the most important thing is to live and invest with passion.